In this video, we're going to finish the circumference and area of circles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website, picking up where we left off in the previous video with number 17. Our directions for 17 through 20 are to find the radius of each circle. We're going to use our calculator's value of pi and round our answer to the nearest tenth. Now in 17 through 20, we're dealing with circumference, so we're going to work backwards given the circumference. So remember, the circumference formula is C equals pi times 2 times r. So if we're given circumference and we're solving for r, our circumference in number 17c is 62.8 miles, and that'll be equal to pi times 2 times r. So what I'm going to do is divide both sides by 2 pi. That way, I'll isolate my r, since pi divided by pi is 1, and 2 divided by 2 is 1. 1 times r is r. And now on my calculator, I'll take 62.8 and divide that by the quantity 2 times pi. So if you need to, write 2 times pi in parentheses to help you remember. And that will give me 9.99, which, rounding to the nearest tenth, is 10.0, or 10 miles, for the radius in number 17. And again, that's 62.8 divided by 2, and then dividing that by pi. So I'll go ahead and do number 19 now as well, since it's on the same side of the page. So circumference, 12.6 yards, equals pi times 2 times r. So if I divide by pi times 2, pi and 2 will cancel out on my right-hand side of my equation to leave me with r, and 12.6 divided by pi divided by 2, or divided by pi times 2, is 2.00, which rounds to 2 yards. So 2 yards is my radius in number 19. Now moving over to 18 and 20, remember circumference C equals pi times 2 r. If I want to, I can rearrange this formula in terms of r. All I have to do is divide by pi times 2. So that'll leave me with r on the right-hand side of this equation, which represents the radius. That's equal to c divided by pi times 2, or 2 times pi. So r equals the circumference, 69.1 yards, divided by 2 times pi. R equals 69.1 divided by 2 times pi, remembering to put 2 times pi in parentheses, that's 10.99, which rounds to 11.0, so 11 yards for number 18. And lastly for this set of directions, number 20. R is going to equal the circumference, 25.1 feet, divided by 2 times pi. That's 25.1 feet. We're dividing that by 2, and then again, dividing that by pi. So that will give me 3.99, which rounds to 4.0, or 4 feet, for number 20. In our next set of directions, we're going to be finding the diameter of each circle, and we're using our calculator's value of pi, rounding our answer to the nearest tenth. So in 21 and 22, we're dealing with area. So remember, area equals pi times r squared. However, we're finding the diameter, and the radius r equals the diameter divided by 2, or we could say that the diameter equals 2 times r. So once we solve for r given the area, we'll then solve for the diameter. So if the area is 201.1 inches squared, that'll be 201.1 equal to pi times r squared. So we'll divide both sides by pi to get 201.1 divided by pi to be 64.01, but as opposed to rounding, I'm going to leave it as 201.1 over pi, and I'm going to take the square root of that quantity, and that is equivalent to r. So right away, if I take the square root of 201.1 divided by pi, I'll get 8.00, which rounds to 8 for my radius. So if 8 is equal to r, I'll take 8 and plug that in for my diameter formula. So d is equal to 2 times 8, so the diameter d is equal to 16, and that's inches, since area was inches squared. So 16 inches is my diameter in number 21. And again, that's because when I take the square root of both sides, the square root of r squared is r, and the square root of 201.1 divided by pi is 8. Now in number 22, area equals pi times r squared. So my area is 78.5 feet squared, and that's equal to pi times r squared. So I'll start by dividing both sides by pi. So if I take the square root of 78.5 divided by pi, that will be equivalent to the square root of r squared, which is r. So the square root of 78.5 divided by pi, making sure that I'm taking the square root of that quantity, I'll get 4.99, which will round to 5.0, or 5. So the radius r is equal to 5. And if the radius is equal to 5, then the diameter d is equal to 2 times that radius, which is 2 times 5, which is 10 feet. So 10 feet is my diameter in number 22. In number 23 and number 24, I'm going to be finding the circumference of each circle. However, I'm going to be using area to find that. So essentially, I'm going to be using area to solve for the radius and then plugging the radius in to my circumference formula. So again, writing the formulas, area equals pi times r squared, and circumference equals pi times 2r, or 2 pi r. So number 23, my area is 64 times pi miles squared. So if my area is 64 pi, that's equal to pi times r squared. So if I divide by pi, essentially my pi's will cancel out on each side. So I'll get that 64 is equal to r squared. And when I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that 8 is equal to r. So my radius is 8. Now in my circumference formula, circumference equals pi times 2r. I'll take c pi times 2 times 8, since that's my radius. 2 times 8 is 16. So I'll have 16 pi for my circumference, since it doesn't tell me to round to my nearest tenth. So I'll leave this answer as 16 pi, but I need to put in my units, and that's miles for circumference. So 16 times pi miles is my solution in number 23. And number 24, again, we're using the same method. Given area, I'm going to be finding circumference. My area is 16 pi, so 16 pi equals pi times r squared, my area formula. When I divide both sides by pi, my pi's will cancel out on each side, and I'll be left with 16 equal to r squared. Lucky enough for me, 16 is a perfect square. So 4 is equal to r. So if I have a radius of 4, when I plug that into my circumference formula, c, circumference, is going to be equal to pi times 2 times our radius of 4. So since it doesn't tell me to round to my nearest tenth, I'll multiply 2 by 4, which is 8, and 8 times pi will be my circumference. So now I just need to write my label of inches. So 8 pi inches is my circumference in number 24. 8 times pi inches. And number 25 and 26, as opposed to finding the circumference given the area, I'm now going to find the area given the circumference. So if the circumference is 6 pi yards, c, the circumference, 6 pi equals pi times 2 times r. So what I'm going to do is divide by 2 times pi. So 2 divided by 2 is 1, pi divided by pi is 1, so 1 times r is r. 6 pi divided by 2 pi, my pi's will cancel out, and 6 divided by 2 is 3. So 3 is my radius. Now for my area formula, area equals pi r squared, I'll just plug in 3 for r. So pi times 3 squared, 3 squared is 9, so that's 9 times pi, and my units is yards squared for area. 9 pi yards squared. And I'm leaving this as 9 pi, the exact value, since it does not tell me to round to the nearest tenth. In number 26, it tells me that my circumference is 22 pi. So the circumference is going to equal pi times 2 times r. So dividing by 2 times pi, my radius will equal 22 divided by 2, which is 11, since my pi's will cancel out. So my radius is 11 inches. Given that my radius is 11 inches, now I can solve for area. Area equals pi times r squared. So area equals pi times my radius of 11 inches squared. So that's pi times 11 squared, which is 121, and that's inches squared. So I'll leave this as 121 times pi inches squared for the area in number 26. And lastly on this worksheet, my critical thinking question. However, before I start this, remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Now, let's go over the critical thinking question. In number 27, it says, find the radius of a circle so that its area and circumference have the same value. So if we want area to equal circumference, that means that pi times r squared, the area formula, will equal pi times 2r. So simplifying, we'll divide both sides by pi, and you can see that r squared will need to equal 2 times r. So now I can subtract 2r from both sides of my equation. So that'll give me that r squared minus 2r is equal to 0. Now I'm going to pull out an r from each of my terms. So pulling out an r, that'll be r times r minus 2 equal to 0. So what values can r be? So in order to get 0, that means that this quantity r has to be 0, or r minus 2 has to be 0. And we know that r is not 0 because if it's a radius, it's a measurement, so we're not going to have a circle with 0 for the radius. However, if r minus 2 was equal to 0, then r would be equal to 2. So our radius would need to equal 2 in order for the area and the circumference to have the same value. And if you want to double check, area equals pi times r squared, so pi times 2 squared, 2 squared is 4, so that's 4 pi, and circumference equals pi times 2 times r, which is 2 times 2, which 2 times 2 is 4, so that's also 4 pi. So when the radius is 2, both the area and circumference of the circle have the same value. Now if you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below. And if you haven't already, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your peers.